Hello and welcome to yet another brand new edition of Colors of India, your weekly cultural diary on Rajya Sabha TV. I am Teena Jha with all the latest on the cultural front in the week gone by. Let's begin with the highlights of all that we've got for you in today's episode. First up this week, an exhibition of Kanthas, the rural art of Bengal. Next, an urban Hindi comedy play. And finally, an introduction to one of the oldest known photographic printing processes. Let's first take you to an exhibition, The Needle Reverence, which traces the stories and the themes within one of India's oldest styles of embroidery, Kantha. From a humble beginning as a homegrown handicraft to today's high fashion statement, Kantha stitch has indeed come a long way. So here's a display of the living heritage that must be nurtured and preserved for the future.
To introduce people with the rich history of Kantha, the quilt embroidery of Bengal, Marti, Management of Art Treasures of India, in collaboration with Art Consult, the Willett Gallery and Art and Deal magazine, recently presented an exhibition at the India International Centre in Delhi. The exhibition titled The Needle Reverence showcased a variety of innovative contemporary Kanthas from the late 19th century till pre-independence, inspired by Indian sculptor Meera Mukherjee's work.
Kantha basically comes from the word rags, which means cut out jo kapde hote hain usko jod jod ke ek badi lambi si कांथा या क्विल्ट बनाया जाते हैं और ये सिर्फ औरत ही बनाते हैं आदमी नहीं बनाते इसको एंड फंक्शंस ऑफ कांथाज आर वेरियस क्विल्ट होते हैं टेबल कवर होते हैं बुक कवर होते हैं बैठने के लिए आसन होते हैं तो ये सारा फंक्शंस पे जिसको डिज़ाइन औरत ही बनाते हैं
These beautiful, traditional and contemporary Kantha on display have been collected over many years and are part of Siddharth Tagore's textile collection. Some of these even date back to pre-partition days of West Bengal and East Bengal. Now, Kantha is considered one of the oldest forms of Indian embroidery, the history of which can be traced back to the Vedic ages. Kantha, which means rags in Sanskrit, emulates the fact that the embroidery is made by recycling discarded clothes into a graceful wholeness.
उन जमाने में कभी हम वो नहीं बनाते कुछ चीज बेचने के लिए ये जो भी चीज बनाते थे किसी को गिफ्ट करने के लिए तो ये आदमी के पास टाइम नहीं होता या तो खेत में होते थे रूरल और देवर डूइंग सम अदर ट्रेडिंग बिजनेस देवर नेवर एट होम वीमेन हैड टाइम एम्पल टाइम एंड दे वुड स्टिच दिस कांथा कांथा इज नोन बाय इट्स स्टिच एंड वो सिंगल स्टिच नीडल को करके वो एक और फिर दूसरा करते थे कलर में कलर भी वही करते थे डिज़ाइन बट यूनिक थिंग इज कि वो विलेज रूरल वुमेन होते हुए इतना अच्छा डिज़ाइन करते थे डिज़ाइंस आल्सो नाउ टुडे पीपल थिंक इवन इट्स अ सिंपल लाइन बट इट्स हैज अ वेरी सिंबॉलिक मीनिंग
आई एम वेरी फॉन्ड ऑफ टेक्सटाइल्स एंड कांथा इज अ वेरी स्पेशलाइज्ड एंड वेरी ब्यूटिफुल क्राफ्ट वेयर द नीडल इज यूज्ड टू बेसिकली स्टिच टुगेदर क्लोथ्स or fabrics that would otherwise be thrown away, whether they are saris or Bengali dhotis.
The The journey of these exquisite pieces is very interesting. Initially, kanta stitching was part of the household work of women in Bengal. These women recycled old sarees to make bedspreads, wraps and coverings for various objects. Gradually, this homely piece of cloth embroidered by a woman began to be used for a newborn or her family as a personal, intimate expression of her love, memories and aspirations. The best part about kanta are its simple patterns, attractive motifs and complicated designs. Kanta's eternal beauty is also a symbol of socio-economic emancipation. After partition, the quilted embroidery was used as a way to provide livelihood to displaced women from across the border. The complexity of stories that were told through these embroideries extended to allegories and folklore, legends and religious themes that also attracted viewers' attention. The exhibition was indeed a treat for art and textile lovers, offering them a glimpse of the country's oldest quilting tradition.
Kanta is a unique, naive and utilitarian form of folk art depicted on textiles. Originally a rural art of Bengal, executed in the early days by the economically deprived families who could not afford quilts. Kantas were also made by mothers and grandmothers as a customary gift to express their love for the newly born. This particular exhibition in Delhi displayed kanta work from the late 19th century till pre-independence. And contemporary kanta created in the 1900s, initiated by the renowned sculptor, the late Meera Mukherjee. We hope you like this world-class collection of both traditional as well as contemporary kanta work. With that, time for a short break on the program. Lots more lined up for you on the other side. Do stay with us. On the other side of the break, a Hindi comedy play. Welcome back. Bollywood films influence us in more ways than one. The way we dress up, the way we speak, and perhaps even our lifestyle. We introduce you to a character who's so much in love with Hindi cinema that he wants similar twists and turns in his life as well. But when he gets everything easy in life, he's upset. He then endeavors to break the monotony of the obvious and turns the predictable into unpredictable. Take a look.
Navras Theatre Group put up a delightful comic play in Delhi this week.
आप अपने कान बढ़ाइए और मेरे म्यूजिक का मजा लीजिए. सारे गामा मा मा.
As the name suggests, the play, jaisa filmon mein hota hai, was a humorous take on how films can influence our love lives.
प्ले के थ्रू हमने ये दिखाने की कोशिश की है कि अगर आपने कभी ध्यान से सुनी एक शायरी है कि मिल जाए तो मिट्टी है, खो जाए तो सोना है. तो एक हमारा लड़का लीड एक्टर होता है, वो किसी लड़की को प्यार करता है और बहुत इजीली मिल जाती है. तो वो कहता है कि यार ये क्या हुआ, ऐसा तो कोई ड्रामा नहीं हुआ. यानी कि कोई चीज़ इजीली मिल जाए तो उसकी वैल्यू नहीं होती है.
देखिए, फिल्मों की बात थोड़ी फ़र्क होती है, लेकिन थिएटर जो होता है उसमें डायरेक्ट कॉन्टैक्ट होता है. हम स्टेज पर खड़े हुए हैं, सामने हमारे ऑडियंस है, वो हमें लाइव देख रहे हैं. फिल्मों में ये चीज़ नहीं होती. लाइव जब देख रहे हैं, और वो डिपेंड करता है कि हम किस तरह का परफॉर्म करते हैं जिससे कि हमारा कॉन्टैक्ट एक एस्टेब्लिश हो जाए ऑडियंस के साथ. और अगर हमारा कॉन्टैक्ट एस्टेब्लिश हो जाता है तो हमें लाफ्टर्स भी मिलते हैं, लोग अप्रिशिएट भी करते हैं.
Written by Umesh Pandey and directed by Raj Upadhyay, the 90-minute family drama tickled the funny bones.
Police wale apni vardi ka utna fayda nahi utha pate jitna unki biwiyan uthati.
Based on the modern day impact of cinema on real lives.
Aap inko saale bhaiya hi bolega. Kya naam diya hai vardi bhaiya aapne?
The play won the heart of the audience with their impeccable dialogues and Bollywood punches. The plot revolves around the protagonist Pulkit, a hardcore Bollywood movie buff who ardently wishes to incorporate the exaggeration, drama and unpredictability of films in his love life. In the opening scene, the play showed how Pulkit, who often visits his sister's place, falls in love with Vishakha, the youngest daughter in the Joshi family. Like every Bollywood film, Pulkit wanted his love life to be full of twists and turns. But he gets worried when everyone in the family, including the girl, agree to his proposal and decide to get them married immediately.
This whole story revolves around the protagonist, a boy called Pulkit, who is the brother of the daughter-in-law of the house. And I'm the mother of the daughter-in-law's husband, Atin. So my character is usually that of a mother, where I'm sometimes a dominating wife, sometimes I'm a indulgent mother. So the plot moves around this boy Pulkit, who comes into the house and who sort of falls in love with the younger daughter of the house. And then after a while, you know, the situation begins to get out of hand because he's a movie buff and he wants to do everything according to how it happens in the movies. And he's very taken aback when he expresses his love to his girlfriend, which is Vishakha and the daughter of the house, and she also accepts it. And then the family also is overjoyed and they said, fine, great, if you two have gotten ready to marry, let's get you married. But he's very upset and disappointed because he wants a little slower pace of wooing and courtship. He wants, you know, all the tadka masala that goes off in the Hindi movies.
Set in an urban locale, the farcical comedy emphasized how people do not appreciate anything that comes easy. It was depicted brilliantly by Pulkit in the play.
There is some big communication gap here. ये जो letter है ना, ये मैंने आपके लिए नहीं लिखा था.
विशाखा के लिए था
ना. ना ना ना.
To make his love life gloom like in Bollywood films, Pulkit cooked up a plan to delay the wedding and inject some excitement into their lives.
थिएटर से लाइफ की सिचुएशन को एग्जैगरेट करके पॉइंट क्रिएट किया जाता है उससे, क्योंकि अगर हम देखें तो ऐसे बातचीत करने में कई दफ़ा चीज़ें समझ में नहीं आती हैं, लेकिन थिएटर से एग्जैजरेशन होता है, पॉइंट दिखाते हैं तो वो कुछ समझ में आना शुरू होता है.
थिएटर से मुतासिर होकर जो आदमी आजकल फिल्मों का ज़्यादा क्रेज़ है, लेकिन इसमें जो स्टेज से निकल जाता है वो जाता है फिल्मों में ही. उनका मेन जो मकसद होता है कि यही है कि थिएटर से मैं फिल्मों में जाऊँगा, तो हम फिल्म वालों को थिएटर में ला रहे हैं.
Pulkit, who played a movie buff, left no stone unturned to make his character memorable.
I love you, love you, love you.
His aspiration to impress his lady love with filmy poses and dialogues amused everyone. The play had 15 actors. Each of them played their part perfectly. Equal attention was also given to their costume, acting and dialogues, making the play all the more enjoyable for all age groups.
What a brilliant depiction of the impact of reel on our real lives. We hope you too liked this entertaining presentation by this group of actors. Time for another quick break on the show. Still more coming up ahead. Don't go anywhere. On the other side, a workshop on cyanotype printing process. Welcome back once again. Let's now take you to a workshop that tells you all about the cyanotype printing process. One of the oldest known printing processes, cyanotype is one of the easiest, safest and most versatile of the alternative photographic processes. Through this workshop, you will get to know a brief history of cyanotype and the simple chemistry behind the process.
To create awareness about cyanotype, one of the oldest photographic printing process, the International School of Design organized a workshop in Delhi recently. Conducted by visual artist Anoop Ray, the focus of the workshop was to teach people how they can create photographic prints at home with a few special materials and gift digital pictures printed as cyanotypes to their loved ones.
We are doing cyanotype workshop, which is the oldest form of printing of a photograph, and nowadays you can transfer it to any fabric or canvas or even glass and make a nice portrait. The only flaw is that it can only be done in blue color since it's a very old technique.
This form of printing is certainly a very beautiful way of fusion, like creating photographs with the antique technique. So I was very excited to do it, and I think I loved the experience.
During the workshop, Anoop Ray demonstrated to participants the various stages of the cyanotype process. The participants brought a variety of flowers and other natural materials, including leaves, flowers and feathers, to create unique designs using this vintage photographic printing technique. The cyanotype is a photographic printing process that produces a cyan blue image when paper, which is made light sensitive, is exposed to ultraviolet light. It is said to be one of the first known silver technologies used to create photographic images.
Every art form have their beauty, and cyanotype, it's have a beauty called the blue print. Like, you can see the blue and other tones of blue, and we can do it on this paper as well as we can use it on canvas. And this printing process have that own beauty, and for that process we learn a lot of things, like how we create the art piece and how we made the art. And this is a piece of art. It's not a daily routine printing process. And it's need certain kind of practice with the chemicals and the paper.
Photographs are the best ways to collect memories. In this digital age, when almost everyone has a smartphone, capturing thousands of images is no big deal. But in ancient times, people used different techniques to collect their memories from past days, and cyanotype is one of them. The process, also known as the blueprint process, was first introduced by English scientist Sir John Herschel in the 1840s. In this process, equal amounts of chemicals, potassium, ferric cyanide and ferric ammonium citrate are used to make a solution. With the help of a brush, this solution is first applied on paper or fabric and then it is left to dry in a dark room. Different sized objects are then placed onto it, of designs that one wants to create. After this, it is placed in the sunlight for a few minutes before washing it in running water. A light safe area is considered best for sensitizing the fabric or paper, while for drying, it is kept in a dark room.
We put the chemical in an equal proportion, mix it, and then we put a layer, very gentle layer, and we have two techniques. One is roll technique, another one is brush techniques. We use the roll technique over here. Over here you can see the brush strokes, and this is the brush technique. So roll technique have an even tone rather than this have a brush strokes.
It's actually a natural process, and how the chemicals react and the picture comes out. And the best part is that you just can't visualize what will be the end product. So there is an element of surprise always. And before even printing the final product, you have to visualize so many things. And then it makes use of natural things, and your creativity stimulates your creativity. And that indigo is my all-time favorite color, which is a unique quality of cyanotype. So it was amazing and a lot of learning. I'll take back a lot of learning, and it's amazing. Now it has opened a new world of experimenting and, art, experimenting with different things.
The workshop was no less than a treat for photography enthusiasts. Participants not just enjoyed the session, they also tried their hands on the cyanotype process. The USP of the cyanotype process is its impressive blueprint and scope for experiment. The ancient photographic technique enables one to be experimental as well as creative at the same time.
And time now for our weekly cultural calendar, where we tell you all about the upcoming cultural events in your city. Mumbai will host the Lakshmikant Pyarelal Utsav at Shanmukhanand Hall, Harbans Lal Marg, 7 p.m. on 19th April. For classical music lovers in Bengaluru, a musical evening Aramb will be held at Forum Shanti Niketan Mall, Whitefield Main Road, 6 p.m. on 20th of April. National capital Delhi will host an English play, Whirlpool, at Dhan Mill Compound, Chhatarpur, 7:30 p.m. between 19th April to 21st April. An oil painting workshop will be held at Loft Viman Nagar in Pune at 3 p.m. on 21st April. And Hari Katha by Vishakha Hari will be held at the Music Academy, TTK Road, Chennai, 6:30 p.m. on 15th of April. You can also send us details of important cultural events taking place in your city. You can write to us on sabrang.rstv@gmail.com. We'll try and include those in our weekly culture calendar. You can also send us your feedback and suggestions about our program. In case you missed the television broadcast, you can also watch the episode on YouTube as well as Twitter. So that's it from us this week on Colors of India. We'll be back same time next week with another brand new edition. Until then, take good care of yourself. It's a goodbye from the entire team.